Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. There was a supposed 2.3 earthquake along the New Madrid fault zone today at 3:11 p.m. local time at Caruthersville, Missouri. Using Google Earth, here we have England City Park, which is not far from there. And here we have the Mississippi River. It's right on the border with Missouri and Tennessee. I downloaded two different monitors. This one right here, BRGM. And to the east, we downloaded CACT. This earthquake, in fact, was actually stronger than what USGS said. It was a magnitude 2.49, almost a 2.5. And we'll look at the spectrogram. There it is right there. And there was also three other very small quakes that USGS is not reporting. We got one right here. There's the spectrogram. It came in as a magnitude 0.7. That would have been 10:18 a.m. local time. And then we got another one right there. That would have been at 2:10 p.m. local time. We'll look at its seismic signature. There it is. And then we'll go to the other one. There's its seismic signature. Both this one and this one was a magnitude 0.7. Very small earthquakes. So actually, it was three earthquakes today, but they are not reporting these really small ones. And they're actually closer to this earthquake monitor right there, CACT. These earthquakes are what's considered interplate earthquakes. They really don't know why there is earthquakes that are not along actual fault zones. But the New Madrid fault zone is a failed rift system that seems to have, of late, been reactivated. Yeah, heaven help us if it does ever decide to separate the United States east from the west. Now, this earthquake was mostly tectonic in nature. You can see the sharpened points. Some a little bit rounded, but I wanted to see what was going on when I pulled the files. And see, this is harmonic tremors. And I was looking at that only because, one, it's a rift system where we got spreading going both east and west. And also, off to the west, not far from here, we have the St. Francis Mountains volcanic, I don't know if you want to call it a chain or whatever, but there's several volcanoes within this area. And this area actually developed at one time as a volcanic island when it was at one time surrounded by the ocean. And then because of tectonic movement, it slowly moved going north and it all dried up. And now we have this volcanic mountains. So, yeah, you can take from that what you will. Like I said, we got spreading going on. And where they're spreading, yeah, you often have volcanic activity. Yeah, can you imagine that if something like that happened? And there is old volcanic fields in this area towards the northeast of today's earthquake or earthquakes is what's called Hicks Dome. That is an ancient volcano, and there's also areas of dike intrusion where lava came up and flowed out. But you can see here the formation, how, yeah, it is an ancient volcano. You can look up Hicks Dome. So three earthquakes today. This one was, in fact, closer to a magnitude 2.5 and not a 2.3. 14 people now have said they felt it. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4. Let me bring that out for you. Which means it was felt indoors by many people, outdoors by a few. And if someone happened to be resting or taking a nap, it would have woken them up. Windows, dishes, and doors were rattling, And automobiles would have been rocking. If you took a look out at parked automobiles, you would have seen them probably rocking back and forth. So intensity level 4 for Caruthers. 11 people said they felt it there. And then down over here, close to Humboldt. And we also have Jackson. We got one response there. So did you feel this earthquake today? Did your pets react? And if so, in what way? Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your support. If you wish to support my channel, you can simply just subscribe and share my videos. Thank you to all of you that do support my channel. God bless you all. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.